Open source is at the heart of the Flutter ecosystem. We all love it and use it daily to speed up and improve our work. However, there are situations when we cannot openly share our work due to intellectual property or security reasons.
So we, Anna and Oleksandr Leushchenko, Google developer experts in Dart and Flutter, will explore a few available solutions for managing private dependencies in your Flutter applications.
A Dart dependency is an external standalone package that can be as small as a single file or as big as multiple files and folders organized into sub-packages to perform a specific task. We create packages to extract some commonly used functionality into a reusable form, or to encapsulate implementation details and hide it behind a simple-to-use facade. Dependency management is a technique for distributing and referencing dependencies in your application's codebase. We specify the configuration for the dependency manager in a well-known pubspec.yaml file. Let's check this simple pubspec.yaml file. Here we have three types of dependency configuration: package A and package B in dependencies, package C in dev dependencies, and package B in dependency overrides. The code from package A and package B version from dependency overrides is available in our project, and the code from package C won't be added to a bundle and is only available in development environment, which is useful for creating tests and helpful tools like analyzer, code generators, and so on. For these dependencies to be available in the project, one of the following commands has to be executed. At this point, pub downloads the latest versions of your dependencies that are compatible with your other dependencies. It then locks your application to always use these versions by creating a pubspec.log file next to your pubspec.yaml file. Here, two types of dependencies are used. Direct dependencies are the library's references directly, and transitive dependencies are dependency of a dependency. Notice that we have specified version constraints in the pubspec.yaml file, but pubspec.log file contains specific versions that are used in the project. Where did the pub.get command get these versions? As you see in the pubspec.log file, it says source hosted, and the URL points to pub.dartlang.org or in short pub.dev. Pub.dev relies on open source principles, as well as the Flutter framework itself.
Flutter has massive community support, with thousands of contributors adding to the framework and extending the package's ecosystem. Everything that was ever uploaded to pub.dev remains there and is publicly available. There are now thousands and thousands of packages for Flutter and Dart from big companies and individual developers. And it is important to keep contributing and using open software for multiple reasons. This way, anyone can access and contribute to the code, which can lead to a more robust and high-quality product. It also gives a more diverse range of perspectives and ideas by promoting collaboration and community involvement. Open source software can be more secure than proprietary software, since the source code is freely available and can be reviewed and audited by a large number of people. Overall, open source software is important because it promotes collaboration, community involvement, security and innovation. However, there are situations where you won't be allowed to publish your work. Let's see what options are available for managing and distributing Dart packages privately.
The simplest and the most straightforward option would be to create a new local package and reference it via pass, in which case it is distributed together with the main project. The minimum required code a new package should contain is its own pubspec.yaml file in a separate directory. It can be referenced like this, And then the pubspec.log file will look like that. Referencing the package by a hard-coded path is simple and is perfect when your goal is encapsulation. But the scope of the dependency is limited to the original project, and it cannot be easily reused across multiple projects.
Using Git solves the reusability problem. It allows depending on the same package from multiple projects. Pushing the new package to the Git repository also ensures only those who have access to the repository can use this package as a dependency. Here are changes that are needed to be done in the pubspec.yaml file. And here is how pubspec.log file is updated. Notice that the log file has a ref property. It is extremely important. You may specify a hash, a tag, or a branch name in a pubspec.yaml file. As a result, the state of the dependency repository corresponding to that hash or tag is downloaded by the pub.get command. We encourage you to always specify the commit hash, as otherwise the latest state of the default branch is used, which may lead to inconsistencies. Let's imagine I referenced the Git dependency without specifying ref and ran pub.get command on my laptop. Then Olex changed something in the dependency package and ran pub.get in the project that uses it on his laptop. As ref wasn't specified, there is no way to find out there were some changes in the repository. So me and Olex will have different behavior in the app. Another option to fix the problem would be to check pubspec.log file in Git, as the ref is specified there. But it's not always possible. It is relatively easy to reference dependencies via Git. As we just saw, there might be some minor inconveniences that are easy to fix. The main disadvantage of this approach is the lack of versioning. The pub command cannot tell which branch or tag is newer, and thus will not know when some version is outdated. This will not be a problem with hosted dependencies.
We all use hosted dependencies each time we reference a dependency. Pub.dev is the default host that is used if no host is specified. All packages published on pub.dev are available publicly, so if you need to distribute a dependency privately, you will need your own pub.dev instance. For that, you may leverage the unpub tool. To create your own hosted dependency server, you need to activate unpub with the following command. Run unpub. You will need to specify a MongoDB database instance that will be used by unpub. Publish packages to your own pub.dev. Specify where to get dependency in pubspec.yaml file. Look at changes in pubspec.log. Important note, probably you would not want to accidentally publish your private packages to a commonly available pub.dev. To secure yourself from this mistake, specify your own pub server in the pubspec.yaml file like this. This approach requires a server to be up and running each time you need to get or update a dependency, and requires some maintenance. Services like OnePub, Cloudsmith, and others provide a complete solution that you may easily use in your projects. The hosted approach provides the best user experience, but it adds complexity and requires some maintenance, which might be an overkill for simple cases.
We recommend starting with the simplest solution and using local packages referenced by paths first. Only when you need to share packages between different projects, then migrate to the Git approach. We advise migrating to privately hosted packages only when encountering problems with the Git approach.
Happy fluttering!